First thing is to realize you may not even have CTE, because again, we don't know for sure if someone has it. And to not be scared that these symptoms mean you've got it. But the best possible coping mechanism is to realize CTE is not a death sentence. Not everyone with CTE is going to crumble in front of your eyes. Not everyone with CTE commit suicide. Not everyone with CTE has major memory problems when they're young. We don't know a lot about it. And so hope is so critical. And hope for many different things. Number one, hope that in the future, in the near future, we're going to have treatments that are designed and good at being able to actually slow the disease down and maybe even prevent symptoms in the first place. But right now, for someone who thinks they're dealing with CTE, most important thing is to just not give up. Go to a healthcare professional, get specific treatments for specific symptoms. If someone feels like they're really hopeless, get to the next day. Talk to a friend, a clergy member, a loved one. Talk to a suicide hotline. Getting to the next day is so important because the next day might bring a whole different feeling, a whole different outlook. There's ways to feel better. There's ways to improve communication with a loved one. There's ways to stop the behaviors. And there's ways to get to that next day. Hope for the next day, hope for the ability to be treated, hope for some smiles, hope to be able to see the grandchildren. All of that is so critical, and there's reason for it. CTE is not a death sentence. Thinking you have CTE does not mean you have it.